This is the precedent and case studies presentation for a rehabilitation center for sea turtles prepared by Alia, Shakira, Adlin, Aina and Kaigunisa. There are 7 species of sea turtle in the world. 4 out of 7 are found in Malaysia and all of these species are endangered. The sea turtles found in Malaysia are the leatherback green turtle, hawksbill and olive ridley turtle. These sea turtles rarely leave the ocean except to lay eggs in the sand. These turtles face the biggest threats because of human poaching and over-exploitation of their eggs for human consumption. Other than that, hundreds of sea turtles are accidentally captured by commercial fishing industry like long lines and trawl nets. The sea turtles also mistake the plastic debris for food. They are also facing a loss in habitat. We have to preserve sea turtles as they are keystone pieces, which is important for the ocean ecosystem and many communities in their world. Turtles help to control their prey by balancing the marine ecosystem. They are also very important for coastal economies and native communities. Turtle nesting helps beaches, but most of all, they are promoting the health of their environment.
Precedent Studies 1, Moripos Turtle Centre, located in Bagara, Australia, it plays an important role as rehabilitation centre for turtles near the beach site. The main concept was to bring people closer to nature and afford a greater appreciation for the natural environment. The space planning of the building are divided into 3, which are public space, semi-private and private. The facade of the building is timber cladding. This is a 3D animation of how the interior looks like.
The facilities are exhibition area for activities such as learning and reading. The research center that provide the information about the sea turtle and the amphitheater for live seeing turtle. Other facilities are cafeteria, hatchery area and turtle track.
Materials that use is glulam timber and using timber frame structure. The use of the timber meant that the project could achieve a 50-year design life in the corrosive marine climate. The structure found to be the most effective structural design for this material. The features contain sustainability and orientation which result to a good functional of the building.
Second precedent study, which Loggerhead Marine Life Center is located in Juno Beach, United States of America, was built in 1983. It began partnering with other sea turtle organizations in 2014. It plays an important role in promote conservation of ocean ecosystem. The mission and vision of this center is actually to focus on the threatened and endangered sea turtle. Space planning for this building is divided into 3 areas, which is public, semi-private and private. The main attraction of this center is Turtle Yard, where visitors can see the turtles up close and read about how the turtles got there. These are activities and facilities that have been held there, which is educational center, children's research center, exhibit hall, hospital, turtle yard, gift shop and also outdoor hospital. The construction being used in this building is concrete construction because it is high quality due to the control condition in the factory, and it also gives high strength in comparison and can be molded into any shape. This is the time-lapse video on the construction progress of this building.
Moving on to our third case study.
The Palm Springs Animal Care Facility by Swart and Mears Architects, located in Palm Springs, United States, built in the year 2011. Features of the building is they have a water recycling system due to the amount of cleaning and the importance of water conservation. They incorporate green features in their design along with a photovoltaic system to handle up to 30% building energy loads. The concept is a reflect on Palm Springs' unique mid-century architectural heritage. The design integrates traditional mid-century desert design motifs with modern state-of-the-art animal care habitats and support system with an operational flow of people and animals into and out of the facility. The exterior design features a sweeping roof overhang to shade the 3 main public entrances. The space planning of the building shows the main public adoption lobby where adoptions, licensing and related business activities occur. The intake lobby is the admittance of strays, and the education center is a community-oriented multi-purpose room. The building is approximately 2,895 meters square. The constructions and materials used are steel posts and beam with metal stud shear wall system. The animal areas feature materials selected for their long-term durability due to their facility's extensive cleaning.
Here are the comparison of precedent studies.
Synthesis 1. For materials, Glulam timber was the most suitable material that can be used as it is ideal in the coastal type of topology. It's because it both corrosion and decay resistance and also for its tensile strength. For construction, frame structure is the best choice as it provides more room for insulation, inherently sturdy, and better resistant to vibration.
Synthesis 2 building program divided into 3, which private area, semi-private area and public. Private consists of local equipment storage room, administrative space, intensive care center. The semi-private is hatchery tank and hatchery area. And public area is education area and exhibition center.
Synthesis 3 is the activities and facilities that are suitable and interesting to be included in the rehabilitation center. This place including equipment storage room, administrative space, classroom and exhibition hall. The activities include the collection of turtle eggs and relocation to the hatchery and turtle watching.
The first case study is foundation and structure.
We are studying on deep foundation.
Most suitable material is pile foundation. Piles are long columns that are driven into soft ground where they can support their load by friction with the soil. It is used when there is a layer of weak soil at the surface.
Material for the piling is concrete.
It is corrosion resistant and high bending resistant.
Rehabilitation center for a turtle should allow natural sunlight to pass through as lighting is an important element for sea turtle health.
Tensile roof is an ideal solution for open structure for aquaculture building. It allows the transmission of natural light to ensure a pleasant atmosphere, while steel roof resists wind damage better than other roofing choices.
Next is the study of tank for sea turtle. The minimum length should be 4 to 5 times longer than the length of the largest turtle, and the width should be 3 to 4 times longer than the turtle length. For the depth, it must be at least 1.5 deeper than the turtle. Considering the size, if we use larger tank, it can support more water volume, which promotes stable temperature and improve water quality, while smaller tank, it is susceptible to water quality issue, and the depth need to be deep enough for the turtle to flip upside down. Some sea turtle must be reared in individual container to prevent injuries from contact with other turtles. So, tank dividers such as plastic fencing, plastic mesh and PVC mesh is used to spread the turtle. Alternatively, we can place the turtle in different container or compartmentalized tank.
The next case study is the material. Hatchery tank material is divided into 3, polyethylene, fiberglass and concrete. All this material can be made into any size and shape. Both polyethylene and fiberglass are portable and easy to install.
For polyethylene, it comes with various colors to suit our preference. And concrete, the advantage is on wall stiffness.
For the aquarium tank, there is acrylic and glass. Acrylic is less weight than glass, and acrylic can be formed into interesting shape, whereas glass cannot be.
As mentioned before, lighting is very important for the sea turtle, so choosing correct roof material is very important. So we studied on 4 types of roof materials, which are tensile fabric roof, FRP fiberglass roof panel, polycarbonate sheet, and clear fiberglass panel ceilings. The last case study is building materials, which include concrete or masonry and timber cladding. Concrete or masonry has high durability and flood-resistant material. For timber cladding, it is easy to install as it is light. It is also has high insulation properties.
The synthesis for foundation and structure. The first one, one of the reasons deep foundation is used because poor soil condition. Next, in coastal area, concrete piling is suitable as it can avoid corrosion. Thirdly, tensile roof structure is recommended for outdoor space roof, which will be the turtle yard area.
Synthesis of tank for sea turtle. We should provide large tank because it will improve fitness for sea turtle and for them to swim comfortably in the tank. The tank should support up to 40 gallons of water. Next, use PVC mesh as their tank divider to ensure that they will not entangle with it if we use plastic net. Next is the synthesis of case study material. Tank material should be non-corrosive and durable enough to withstand any impact. Fiberglass and polyethylene are the best option for hatchery tank. The advantage of both of these material, it can be molded into any shape and has various size. It is also convenient for the drainage and filtration system for the tank. For aquarium tank, acrylic is the best option for large type aquarium as it gives more advantages compared to glass material. For the roof material, we are focusing more on space for sea turtle, which is the hatchery tank area. Polycarbonate roof is one of the material that commonly used for agriculture and aquaculture in Malaysia because it is suitable for our weather, and this material can provide natural lighting, which is important for the health of sea turtle.
and it also helps to avoid direct sunlight. For coastal area, it is vital to use appropriate material which is resistant to flood and wind damage. The right material will help to reduce the maintenance costs. So, concrete and masonry are the best option material for building in coastal area because of its durability,
good high wind damage, and flood resistance.